Hey guys, today we are checking out Amazon's new smart speaker, the Echo Studio. Now, when this speaker came out, the big news about it was that it can do 3D audio, and the biggest question I had, what does that even mean for a small smart speaker? Well, it turns out it means a lot, and this speaker can do something that virtually no other speaker of its kind can do, and it also sounds pretty good too. Let's check it out. Now before we get to the sound, let's talk about the design here. It's no secret that this is a pretty large speaker, especially when you compare it to the Sonos One and even the Apple HomePod. It's big, it's bold, and it's not going to disappear on your shelf, but that's sort of by design because there are a lot of speakers inside this guy. There is a 1-inch tweeter on the front, two 2-inch drivers on each of the sides. There is a pretty large little woofer in here, 5.25 inches. That is big for a smart speaker, and it does have big bass, but we'll get to that in a second. And there's also a 2-inch driver to fire sound at your ceiling to create that hemispheric sound that you'll get with 360 audio like Dolby Atmos and Sony's 360 Reality Audio. Now at the top of the speaker are some basic controls. There's the action key to call up the voice assistant, whom I will not name here because I don't want to set it off in your house in case you have Echo speakers already. There's also volume control here. And then my personal favorite, the mute key, which turns that rainbow blue Amazon LED to a Darth Vader red, letting you know that the speaker is no longer listening. That is a great thing for people that are worried about having their conversations recorded when they don't want them to be. I love that, and it's really easy to put it in mute mode. Now at the back of the speaker, there's also, of course, the power port, but there's also a 3.5 millimeter / Toslink optical input. Now, if you have the right adapter for that, that allows you to connect this to your television. Although you need to know that you can't get Dolby Atmos sound with an optical input. The only way to get Dolby Atmos from your TV is to connect it to a Fire TV device. And there are a select few that can do that. But then again, I don't really recommend using this speaker as a Dolby Atmos sound system for your TV anyway. That's not what it's for. What it's for is Dolby Atmos music. Now there are plenty of third-party speakers that work with the voice assistant who shall not be named here, but the cool thing about buying from Amazon directly is this does everything Alexa can do. So that's hundreds of commands. You can use it as an intercom system throughout your house. You can use it as a multi-room speaker system. You can use it to control your smart home system and much more, which you can learn more about inside the very simple to use Amazon app. Now, speaking of setup, Amazon's Echo speakers are very easy to set up these days. They borrowed a lot from Sonos, and that's a really good thing. Sonos used to be the king of easy setup, but the Echo speakers are just as easy as Sonos these days, in my opinion. In fact, I didn't even have to enter in my Wi-Fi password to get this set up. You can quickly go through and add all the streaming services that you want to. Simple, easy, and you'll be streaming in no time. Now, when it comes to streaming services, I'm kind of a Spotify person. All of my libraries are there. Everyone has their own streaming service, and this supports many of them, including Apple Music, Pandora, Tidal. But one very cool thing about Amazon Music is it now has HD music for just $5 more. That's higher resolution music, up to 24-bit, 192 kilohertz. Not only that, but as we prefaced at the beginning, it also has 3D audio in the forms of Dolby Atmos music and Sony 360 Reality Audio. Now these are brand new formats, but they can do some very cool things. Now for anybody who knows what Dolby Atmos is when it comes to home theater or cinema, the music side is very similar. Basically, it's called object-based music because you can take any effect, or in this case, any instrument, and place it as an object anywhere inside a 360-degree soundstage. Now, most systems that utilize that kind of format have multiple speakers spread throughout the room. There are a few systems like Sennheiser's Atmos Bar that use 360 DSP and speakers that shoot all across the room to sort of immerse you in sound. And that's sort of the idea of this speaker. You've got the side speakers that shoot sound off your walls, and then the top-mounted speaker that shoots sound off your ceiling to immerse you in sound. Now, I'm not gonna tell you that this can fully get around you, especially at the back, but I was actually amazed when using Amazon's new music service at how well it works. You really do get this sort of blooming sound in the front of the room, and when it's done right, it is quite impressive. Now, Elton John's Rocketman was the best example I've heard. In fact, it's the first time I've ever gotten chills from a smart speaker. The sounds of the spacey effects were bouncing off the walls, bouncing off the ceiling, and while it didn't get to the back of me, it really filled up the whole front of the room in a very cool way. And I really think that not only is Amazon Music going to be very important going forward, but this speaker is gonna be a big part of that. Now, of course, not everybody has Amazon Music, and its 3D audio tracks are pretty limited right now, so most of your listening is probably gonna be either from HD music on Amazon, or more likely compressed music from other streaming services, and that brings the speaker down to earth a little bit. Now, one thing it has really going for it is its bass. I think it is best in class bass. It's firm, it's powerful, it's rigid. Now, this vent right here seems to be a big part of that. It lets air through and it helps control the bass so you get a really powerful sound, but it doesn't sound boomy or sloppy, and that sounds great with hip hop and electronic music especially. It's not all gravy across the board though. There is some muffling, especially in the mid-range with vocals on this speaker. It probably has to do with the fact that there's only one inch tweeter at the front, so you're not getting as much clear mid-range sound from the front. And that's exacerbated with the stereo spatial enhancement mode that's inside the audio settings. I turned that off and it did sound more forward and cleaner and more detailed. However, it also got a little brighter when you turn that off, so it's kind of a trade-off there. Lighter instruments get a little brittle sometimes with this speaker. You're not going to get as rich, smooth, or detailed sound as, say, the Sonos One. That said, whether you're listening to 360 music, HD music, or regular music, the Echo Studio is a serious contender and great competition for the Sonos One. This is the best speaker Amazon has ever made. It does something that almost no other speaker of its kind can do, and I'm really excited to see what it can do going forward. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. If you like what you've seen here, please give us a thumbs up, drop a comment in, and I'll try to answer as many of those as I can. More videos like this are right over here, and we'd also love it, of course, if you'd subscribe to our YouTube page.